pod people are finally making their way to life in Black Lightning, and it is not a letdown after a season and a half of build-up. I feel like Black Lightning is back on track after the whole Runaway arc. So much build-up is being paid off finally. After the fallout of season one with Jefferson losing his job, he almost gets it back before making an alternative decision, which I think is the right choice for him because he's going to be busy moving forward. The briefcase that we've been being teased about since season one apparently holds the keys to the Masters of Disaster, and we meet our first member who is released thanks to Tobias, and he can control them. But Shakedown managed to help Tobias and Cutter steal all of the pod kits while the ASA compound was on lockdown. Fortunately, Lynn was able to wake up Winter, a girl who showcased her powers earlier this season. On the opposite side, it seems to be a development between a Thunder and Lightning team-up that we could be getting eventually. I kind of like this side because they don't like their dad's can-do approach about things, so they want to take matters into their own hands, vigilante style. But Jennifer learned that she could essentially become a nuclear bomb. Anissa learned that Grace isn't exactly who she said she was. But as Jennifer tests her powers more, it leads her to going after Tobias on her own, thinking she can handle it, but she overexerts herself and ultimately passes out. And thanks to Jennifer, she is actually saved. But ultimately, by the end of the episode, Tobias stands to have control of all the pod kids and the Masters of Disaster. But I do think that Cutter has ulterior motives besides, you know, shagging up with Tobias, and Shakedown looked like he didn't really like working with Tobias or the Duck. We also know the Markovians are still after them as well. So this is going to turn out to an all-out war of sorts by the end of the season, hopefully. But with Jennifer being on the path to controlling her powers a bit more, Grace set to return, and Winter being awake once again, Tobias may have a problem on his hands. But this episode is another 9.5 out of me. These have been a solid few episodes, and this next episode is full of so many payoffs that I'm ready to see where this goes. But let me know what you think down below.